looking at the stimulus of a neuron, with most neurons, our resting membrane potential is going to be negative 70 millivolts because we have more sodium on the outside of the membrane. We have more potassium on the inside, but relatively speaking, we've got more positive charges total on the outside of the membrane versus the number of total positive charges on the inside. So we have a relative negative millivoltage on the inside of the membrane of the cell. So if we have stimulus that takes us from negative 70 millivolts to negative 55 millivolts, that number, that negative 55, is what we refer to as threshold. As long as we have enough stimulus to hit threshold, what happens is sodium voltage gated channels will open up at threshold. Sodium voltage gated channels open up, and then sodium comes into the cell, bringing its positive self inside so that the inside of the cell becomes more positive all the way up to 30 millivolts, positive 30. Once we hit positive 30 millivolts, those sodium voltage gated channels close. So for depolarization, it's all sodium. Sodium opens at threshold, sodium closes at the peak. But at the peak, another event's going to occur, and that's the potassium voltage gated channel that opens up. So potassium voltage gated channels open up. Now, potassium, remember, there's more potassium on the inside, so it's going to diffuse down its concentration gradient through its voltage gated channel out of the cell, taking its positive cell with it. So if we take positivity away, we become more negative. Now, not only do we get back to our original starting point, but remember that potassium voltage gated channels close more slowly. And because potassium voltage gated channels close more slowly, we actually get a little bit too negative. We become hyperpolarized. So again, we have depolarization dependent upon hitting threshold, depolarization, repolarization, hyperpolarization. And then the resting membrane potential is reestablished by the sodium potassium pump. Now, when we look at neurons, remember that when depolarization is occurring, you can't depolarize again. And even during repolarization, the membrane has to hit a certain point before it could be stimulated with a greater than threshold stimulus to get an action potential. Because remember, action potentials are an all or none phenomenon. They either go because you hit threshold, or they don't go. And when the membrane starts to reestablish itself with repolarization, you do get to a point where you might be able to get, with a stronger stimulus, you might be able to elicit a second action potential. But in this green area, because the membrane is insensitive to any further stimulus, we call this the absolute refractory period. Absolutely no way are you going to get another action potential. In the relative refractory period, which happens when the membrane has started to reestablish itself, and it's about halfway there, okay, or even a little bit more than halfway there, back to normal, that's your relative refractory period. So you might be able to get a second action potential relative to the strength of the stimulus. Okay, so I just wanted to point that out to you guys.